Today in the mod, we are giving Quebec the ability to rebel from Canada, take over Canada, and then reclaim the French colonies of America. And in addition to that, some other comments were randomly selected to be in the mod, specifically France surrenders at the start of the game to literally no one, make a shaky a field marshal for France. I'm not sure if this counts, but seeing as how France owns Madagascar, make Madagascar independent and run by King Julian from the movie Madagascar. And lastly, make a pirate republic in Brittany. All very good additions to the game, and by extent, the mod. So today we will, of course, be playing as Quebec. They probably have the most interesting path in the entire game now, so it's probably a good idea to play as them, and on historical for this one. I don't know how well historical will work, considering there's Greenland here and a swamp here, but I think most things are still in the right place for historical focuses to function properly, at least in version 4. Who knows, it'll happen in later versions. Oh, and I guess I forgot to say, the theme for the next round is something spooky, so leave your spooky suggestions in the comments for next time. But yeah, it's time we get to playing as Quebec as we disable the videos on these things, because I know how to play the game. I know it's surprising, but I also gave Quebec the Japanese Navy and Army tree. Doesn't really work right, but it's better than nothing. We'll start with 1759. And we're a puppet of Canada, and Canada's a puppet of the UK, so we will have to get our independence first, which is pretty much free in the mod, so it's not too big of a deal. I'll just do some random research. I kind of forgot, actually, to give them the ability to get more research slots. I may have to add that in, maybe, but I think we're okay for now. France has capitulated. That's fun. And there's Soblin. Yeah, fun, yeah, good events. Good mod. Okay, so we will do the Tale of Two Cities focus, and then from there we can declare our independence or go a step further and invade Canada and start the Canadian Civil War. Or we can just become a dominion under Britain instead of a puppet of Canada, which is not a good option. It's not good. It's boring, very boring. So we will not do that, definitely. So yeah, the Canadian Civil War has begun. It is going to be kind of difficult because regular Canada has 3 to 18 divisions, so about 10, we have 6. We'll hopefully be able to use this guy to take Halifax. I don't know what's gonna happen here. Oh, yeah. That's not fun. Ideally though, yeah, he's probably gonna walk out of there and then we can walk into Ottawa. I guess the ideal thing to do would have been to encircle Ottawa and just keep it encircled the entire time so no one has supply, but yeah, this division here was kind of messing with that. I guess we'll also do the support from France focus. That's probably the best one. We have these three focuses we can do in the war. We'll probably do support from France and then get planes and then get the steel. Yeah. Yeah, but that ends the Tale of Two Cities, because we occupy the other city here, very close. It's kind of dangerous for both of us to have our capitals that close to each other, but yeah. Canada's divisions are nowhere to be found, so we're safe for now. We'll just take all this and then go to Vancouver, where we will win the war. Okay, yeah, so they finally got their divisions from Vancouver over to the front line, so we'll just keep making small encirclements, doing what we can. But now that I think about it, this mod is kind of evolving into a Nightmare from the North mod for the United States. You have Alaska and Quebec now, and in 3 out of the 4 total versions, we've played as a country that can invade the US from the north. I don't know, that's, it's just weird, I don't know. Maybe I'm just subconsciously obsessed with doing that. Kind of a random thought now, we'll get to that later. And perfect, we are now Canada. We will annex all states because we'll be able to get cores on everything, including Newfoundland and Labrador in time. We'll also be able to invade Alaska. It's actually kind of nice, the blue color in the north. It's kind of cursed a little bit, maybe, to have Quebec over all of Canada, but Besides that, it's all good. And we'll change our name to New France or French Canada soon anyways, so it'll be fine. Okay, and we defeated Alaska, and we have become New France. We have two options here. We can either become French Canada or New France. French Canada turns us into a French puppet state, so it would basically be like playing Canada in vanilla. You would just be a puppet of France instead of Britain. And now we're going to ask our good friend America very, very nicely for Louisiana back. And I don't just mean Louisiana the state, this kind of smallish state down here. It's a nice state and it has a good port, but we don't want just that. We want the entire Louisiana Purchase. It's a much better real estate than just the one state down there, and I'm sure that FDR-san will give it right back to us, all of it, yeah. Napoleon sold it to the US historically, and Napoleon was crazy, so that doesn't count, and we're gonna ask for it back. There's a chance that they give it back without having to go to war. I don't know, I'm pretty sure just a 50-50 chance. I guess it's a coin flip. Hopefully we don't have to invade the US though. We probably could if we really wanted to, but it would be difficult. And they gave it to us, which is good. That's very nice. May make the borders look a little weird, but don't worry about it too much. We have nice Caribbean real estate now in Louisiana, which is a cool place. Missouri, Kansas, that's pretty cool. Wyoming isn't supposed to exist in this mod, so you could ignore it, but see, this here is not the highlight of the focus tree, or really the playthrough itself. This is the beginning, the setup. Unlike Alaska, which kind of had a setup where conquering the US was the end game, this setup is very different because we will be siding with the US, so taking all this stuff, it's kind of a net zero. Well, besides the fact that the US is an AI and is way worse, so me having it is better, but besides that, we'll be joining the Allies, so in the end, it won't make that much of a difference. And the Munich Agreement, peace in our time, celebrate, yeah, well, hopefully not, because if there is peace, then we won't be able to do our thing. So hopefully there's not peace. Okay, and Poland and France and Britain are at war, so we'll see what happens. Things should go normally. There's just a few weird things, like France not having Brittany, but nice. And Trek peacefully joined the Comintern. That's cool. And even with a shaky field marshal, France was not able to hold. But that gives us a nice opportunity to embrace our destiny. Germany will declare on us, but we annex Free France and become France. So instead of Free France, we will be New France. So we're like Canada, France, and a third of America, all combined into one massive nation. Okay, and there we go. We'll join the Allies, we'll sign non-aggression pacts with everybody, but we are now France. Well, we're still New France, but we have cores on all of France. Oh yeah, and we have all of France's army, which is only 8 divisions, because they, I guess, didn't do so well. We did get their navy, though, which is a nice touch. That's the one good thing that came of this. Oh, America joined the Allies really early, too. Oh, I think it's because of us joining the war, and we were guaranteed by them. That's cool, I guess. So, all the Italians are entrenched in East Africa, so I don't think we can conventionally push them, but we can raid them with these sub-3s, because their surface navy can't get out of the Mediterranean yet, so yeah, their convoys are free game as far as I'm concerned. Okay, we've taken this port here. We'll take this port. Then hopefully we'll take this level 6 port. This is the most important one to take. Then they should all really start attritioning. And there, I think this is a pretty big encirclement of the Italians. The Italians are no more. Okay, and very historical. Italy fails to take Greece. Germany invades Yugoslavia to attack Greece. East Africa is cleared up, so we'll go kick the Italians out of North Africa. Okay, we're invading Sicily as the Germans invade the Soviets and try to invade Norway and Greece and fail. And Italy has capitulated to us, New France. We're not even at war with Vichy France yet. Wait, and Vichy France denied giving Japan French Indochina? Which, this is historical, so that must be some issue with, you know, us annexing France. Ah, and perfect, the ghost of Lenin has joined the Comintern, along with... Yeah, and the Soviet Union doesn't have a name, don't worry about it, that's just intended game mechanic. Yeah, now we're invading Vichy France. Germany, Switzerland joining seems to be the thing that is gonna destroy Germany. Yeah, it was all Switzerland. Us capitulating Italy didn't matter at all, but Switzerland and the ghost of Lenin saving the world. Truly an amazing story. Should have built tanks, though. Germany is, like, invincible. They're being attacked across their entire front, but no one can push them. They're too powerful. We'll at least be able to break into Paris, though, I think. Otherwise, we might just have to research some tanks to end this war. Finally beat Germany here. It took a while of pushing through their line, but they finally broke, so now we have all of France, all of northern Italy, and Germany is our puppet state. We're in the Comintern. The Soviets took all of our African colonies and made them puppets, of course, but I think this is pretty good. This is a nice new France. I guess we should probably take out Brittany if we're gonna do anything next, but yeah, that's it for version 4. Remember to leave your spooky recommendations for version 5, and I will get to that, whatever that ends up being. Anyways, I will see you then.